Hello, it's Oliver Chris here with a big welcome to a quick butcher's behind the scenes of the first series of Green Wing. Stay with us for the next 10 minutes and you'll get to see a host of cast, crew and camels, pants and tantrums, and possibly a little bit of nudity, so watch out for that. First up, meet some of the on-screen team.
Okay, and
Michelle Gomez, our token Scott.
What's wrong with it?
Julian Reintutt, our token ginger, strawberry blonde. Stephen Mangan, a man that defies introduction. Tamsin Gregg, fresh from Black Books and the Archers.
Just stop it, okay? All right?
Sarah Alexander, fresh from Smacking the Pony.
I need to know objectively which is better. A, my bottom, B, my lips, or C, my breasts. Nipples.
Carl Theobald, previously a small stand-up comedian. The award-winning Pippa Hayward. And my on-screen sparring partner, the lovely Mark Heap, who claims to be mainly motivated by
money.
And we're all in the gentle care of our two lovely directors, Tristram Shapiro and Dominic Brigstock, and the series producer, creator and co-writer, Victoria Pyle, our great leader and overall boss lady. After months of scripting and several weeks before filming began, the cast joined the team of writers for a grueling series of rehearsals and workshops. These continued between our shooting blocks, allowing us to hone our skills to perfection. So, no time off then. Here's me and Sarah Alexander learning how to cartwheel. See how effortlessly I outperform her in every rehearsal. Then on the day, well, it's actually hard to believe it's really us.
Not bad.
Cheers.
Carl Theobald also got the one-on-one treatment, this time with a choreographer to work up his dance routine for episode 6. The work had to go on for day after day after day, giving Carl the opportunity to live out his fantasy of being Jennifer Beals in Flashdance. One day, Carl. One day. Steve and Julian worked with a fight director to block their big argument in episode 7. Everything was carefully worked out in rehearsal, but on the day it takes a little bit of time to hit the rhythm they achieved off camera and the scene takes a little while to get in the can.
Cut!
Or maybe they just like the close physical contact.
I did feel a little bit of contact there. Yeah.
One of the perks of the job.
You'll probably have spotted that we shot Green Wing at a real hospital. Here we are clogging up the passage of all the proper doctors and sick people. Actually, we filmed in two hospitals, so we didn't monopolise anything too important for too long, like the operating theatres. Even so, the programme's authentic look depends on being able to coexist with proper hospital activities. We're in a busy working institution which can't be closed down. Normally, this would present a bit of a problem with conventional shooting, where scenes are repeated to get shots from different angles. But our secret weapon is Green Wing's naturalistic shooting style. Camera operator Martin Porter covers entire scenes in one long, continuous move, often using a Steadicam. Then editors Billy Snedden and Lucian Clayton speed up and slow down the flow of time to get from one scene to the next. This also has the added benefit of hiding the odd moments where the actors forget their lines.
You're missing me.
Everybody in this hotel.
It's not a hotel.
It's Crossroads.
It's not a hotel.
This is us turning up in the morning bringing a lot of very complicated technical equipment. Although these trucks you can see here mainly contain Stephen Mangan's hair. The many specialist staff required to tease it into its natural curls are only a fraction of the 60 or so crew people it takes to make Green Wing, and that's not even including us actors. The best way to attract these skilled technicians is to lure them with large amounts of food several times a day. By serving up a total of 19,530 meals over the course of the shoot,